What do you want to accomplish in 2020?
Take it away, guys.
Boy, this broadcast is full of talent. We talk about amazing.
Let's see who wins. We hope you enjoyed every bit of it.
You don't remember freshman year? Well, maybe we need to refresh our memory of the past decade.
I am the chick magnet!
My new club is starting Monday in room 315.
Wow, I forgot all the amazing things that happened last decade.
We sent our broadcasting team all around Wichita to check out interesting places. Do you not remember this?
Thanks, guys. We loved all of your responses. It may be the most exciting part of the year.
What's up, BCTV? Welcome back to sports.
I mean, what else would we do? All right, seniors. Let's save this broadcast. We can do this. As long as we're together, we'll win.
Hey, Bishop Carroll, it's George Walden, anchoring from home here today. And we're getting so close to the end of the school year, and I've just got a couple reminders for you guys, just reminding you to stay the course and keep going strong. Online learning for seniors continues through May 14th, and online learning for 9th through 11th graders continues through May 21st. And we're working on a plan for returning textbooks. All textbooks must be returned in good condition, and we will be sending out details at a later date. As I mentioned before, we're getting very close to the end of the year, and teachers wanted to give some words of wisdom. Let's check it out.
Hey class of 2020, Mrs. A here, and my advice to you would be to first surround yourself with the very best people that will bring out the best in you. Make sure they're people that love you for you and want you to become the best version of yourself and not another version of them or another version of somebody else. So that would be my first thing. The second thing I would tell you is to give yourself some grace. Life is about lessons and learning, and remember, it's not how well we execute plan A, but how well we cope with plan B. And the last thing I would tell you is remember that you are loved immensely and you were created in love, and there are a multitude of people that care about you, including me. And so go out and change the world, say your prayers, and make good choices.
Class of 2020, I got a piece of advice for you. Look, set a goal, set a dream, make it big, and then work towards it. You'll stumble along the way, weird stuff will happen to derail you for a minute, but get up and keep working towards that dream, and that's what's going to keep you going. Work hard. Proud of you.
Hey, seniors. Mr. Ebride here. Hey, I know a lot of you guys, a lot of the seniors, there's a few I don't, but it's been a crazy year, but I got to tell you, I really enjoyed our time together, and want to just give you some advice as you move on. A lot of you guys will be going off to college. One of the things you got to make sure is you don't have too much fun your freshman year, okay? What goes on your transcript as a freshman stays on your transcript forever. So make sure you're, staying up on your studies. Guys, haven't been at Carroll for a long time. I really understand the importance of faith and your Catholic identity, your Catholic community. Stay true to those. Some of you will stray, I know, but the church, your family, your community will always welcome you home. So please stay on the straight and narrow. Have fun, but not too much fun. And I hope you are able to achieve all your dreams. You know you can do that through hard work and reliance on God. I want to wish you all the best. Take care.
Hi, seniors. Congratulations on your graduation. I can't wait to get to see you walk across the stage in July. I just wanted to pop on here and say how grateful I am to have gotten to know some of you in my first year at Bishop Carroll. It has been truly a pleasure and joy to be your teacher and say hi to many of you in the hallways. I know this semester ended a lot sooner than we expected, but I am just so proud of your perseverance and your willingness to keep going and remain positive during this time. You are going to do absolutely incredible things as you move on with your future, and I can't wait to watch you along your journey. Congratulations again, and I'll see you soon.
Hi,
Hi guys. I'm not even sure where to start with this senior video, but I just wanted to say bye. You know, some of you had sophomores and I just was looking so forward to having you and finishing out this semester, and then I got you and then bam, this all hits. But I just want to remind you about your bucket list. If you've had me, do those bucket lists. Give them to your mom so she holds on to them. Make sure you're crossing something off and let me know when you finally do. Remember to write greeting cards. Remember to put full thoughts and give your love to everybody. And I wish you just the very best that life has to offer. Remember to keep your faith. Stay close to your friends. They will be the bricks that help you build your whole life together. Come back and see us. Send me notes so that I know how you're doing. But otherwise, I wish you all the best in the world.
Hey, seniors. Here we are in your lunchroom. Look who we have here.
Hi.
Sister Mary Dolores says hello. It's pretty lonely around here, as you guys can see. Oh, hello, sisters. It's a little video for our seniors. We miss you. We miss them much, don't we? It's very lonely around here.
Hi, seniors. I just wanted to take this opportunity to congratulate you for everything that you've accomplished over the last 4 years at Bishop Carroll. And I guess moving forward into your future, a little bit of advice I would have for you. Number one, stay focused, have a goal, and work hard to achieve it. Number two, have a little fun. Fun is always good. There's a whole lot of have-tos in life, so once in a while, if you're able to take advantage of a want-to, go for it and have some fun doing it. And then number three, your faith. Keep your faith, keep it strong, go to church. It'll help you get you through a lot of tough times. All right, that's all I got for you, seniors. Congratulations and best of luck with your future.
Hey, seniors. Wanted to share with you one of my favorite quotes by Mark Twain that goes something like this. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the ones that you did. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, and catch the trade winds in your sails. God bless you guys.
I'm sitting on my front porch, a familiar place for those seniors I have this semester. It's been our place of drop off and pick up. And I just wanted to share a word of wisdom that's taken from A Letter to Artists by the great Pope John Paul II. And he says that all men and women are entrusted with the task of crafting their own life. And in a certain sense, they are to make of it a work of art, a masterpiece. So here's to your masterpiece, its continuation, and all of my best hopes, wishes, prayers are with you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, seniors. It's finally the end of the road here for you. Many of you are going off to college. Good luck there. Don't wait till your junior year to figure out what you want to major in. Many of you are going into the military. In advance, thank you for your service to our country. It means a great deal. And many of you are going out to the workforce. Regardless of where you're going, make sure you continue to have a right relationship with God. All your other relationships will work out great if you stay close to Jesus, stay close to God, and make Him the priority of everything that you do. God bless.
Seniors, what a wild ride these last couple months have been. But now the end is here. These last couple months, you have been tested and you've proven yourself. And now it's time to make memories somewhere else. You are ready for whatever lies ahead. I am so proud of you and all you have accomplished. I wish for you happiness and all the best in the future.
Thanks, teachers, for those great words. Our music department was not able to have Golden Review 2020, so instead they decided to do some other activities to make up for their missed concert. Those activities include posting a photo watching your favorite Disney movie, watching the Disney family sing-along, and posting a video singing or lip-singing to a song that would have been part of a Disney Magic Golden Review performance.
How does a moment last forever? How can a story never die? It is love we must hold on to. Never easy, but we try. Sometimes a happiness is captured.
I can hear you, but I won't. Some look for trouble, while others don't. There's a thousand reasons I should go about my day and ignore your whispers, which I wish would go away.
I've been staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try.
We have some talented individuals at BC. Now let's go over to Mr. Pinkerton to check out bridge breaking.
This is my bridge. I'm Edwin Lopez, and it held 243 pounds.
This is my bridge, Unbreakable, and it held 295 pounds.
I'm Nathan. My bridge held 421 pounds.
Hi, my name's Abby. This is my bridge, Filibuster, and it held 596 pounds.
Wow, that was impressive. Now we're going to turn it over to the school president and vice president for some announcements.
Hello, everyone. I'm Grace Rosa, your student body president.
And I'm Preston Rottinghouse, your student body vice president. With teacher appreciation going to be this week, we asked some of our fellow students to submit videos saying what they were grateful for.
Thank you, teachers, for always helping us with our problems.
Thank you, teachers, for always being there for me when I need you and never giving up on me.
Thank you, teachers, for not only guiding me in my academics, but in life in general over the last 4 years.
Thank you, teachers, for encouraging us to be our best selves.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A funny story I had from high school would be definitely from broadcasting, when one time we had no clue what to do. So Ms. Coburn was asking us, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? And I just grabbed a camera and I'm like, I'm going to go film my broadcast real quick. And I just left the room, and it was second lunch and we have third lunch. Ms. Coburn was like, what are you doing? And she was pretty mad at me that day. It was funny.
Now that we've looked back on this past year, we can start looking ahead to the next. Preston and I are so excited to start leading you and to start making new changes to Carol. Some of the improvements that we're looking at making is helping form the freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior leadership positions in the houses into having more of a role in the community system. We also want to work a lot closer with the house captain so that we can help fix the problems not just occurring on a school-wide or community-wide level, but within your own houses that you all deal with every day. These are just some of the many things that Preston and I are looking at helping change next year, and we are excited to start working on them with the future community coordinators and house captains. Speaking of which, let's send it back to Preston to talk about the upcoming elections.
With elections beginning on Thursday, I encourage all of you to go vote. Don't let your voice go to waste. Thank you, and have a good rest of your week, you guys.
Well, that was a wrap for this week, folks. But remember, if you'd like to run for prom coordinator, please fill out the form, and you can get that form from your house teacher or find it in the BC community Twitter or Instagram page. And a big congratulations to our National History Day students. Students who got first or second in their category qualify for a national contest in June. Third place finishers are alternatives for nationals. And before we sign off, we have some of our favorite outtakes and bloopers from this year. So enjoy and stay safe, BC.
Hold on. Okay.
Now I'm even more excited for Halloween. Crap.
Kyle, boot or beef?
Beef?
Donald. No. And I go, oh, and then they start laughing. That's your...
What?
Look at how bad I'm shaking.
Oh shoot, I don't even have a costume yet.
I'm sorry.
The way she looked at me was like...
That was legit.
That was legit.
Did we... Was six good?
I think... I thought it was.
Ignore that. This is about me.
Hey Adler, did you know that our own Mr. Davidson is an orange belt in karate?
Are you serious?
Let's hope Daniel doesn't get paralyzed.
No.
hello, BCTV. Today I'm here with a new skit, Water Fountain Review.
Sounds good.
I want to give a solid 6 out of 10. It's nice, crisp, cold, and good water. That one's more like a 5 out of 10, you know. I could feel it, but you know, it's not great. Now we're going to go over to the ladies' side. That's an 8 out of 10 right there. Solid, crisp, clear, Aquafina type, you know. It's not Dasani. 0 out of 10. I hate it. This tastes awful. How could they do this to the ladies of Bishop Carroll? How could they do this? Back to you guys.